So, fellas, it's toast.
Toast.
Number 10.
Hard in the paint. Cocktail players.
Hard in the paint.
How you doing? Welcome to episode 10 of Hard in the Paint Real Talk. Today we're going to be discussing old school versus new school with my host,
White Boy Dave,
Crispin Alapag,
and Cedric Sean Bello.
And our guest host,
Ready Freddy.
Great.
So, what do you guys think about old school versus new school as far as the music and just the you know, just with kids and how things have changed?
I mean, we did a little thing back here a couple weeks ago. We were talking about how when we grew up as kids, you know, we had Electric Company, Sesame Street. We had informative cartoons or informative shows that would teach us things. Nowadays, you know, like you watch Morgan Freeman. There you go, my man Morgan Freeman. When Morgan Freeman would be on Electric Company, he'd be like, C-A-T, cat, D-O-G, dog. But for instance, what I'm saying is that the difference is they don't have those type of informative shows to teach even the younger ones in comparison to shit. The older ones need some advice as well, or some teachings as well.
But, and I think with the technology these days, what I noticed, because I have two young boys, they don't even watch TV anymore. They're mainly on their iPads or their iPhones. And I think the thing we all used to look forward to when we were younger is waking up for those early Saturday cartoons. My kids aren't waking up to watch Saturday day cartoons. Right. They're on their iPad or their iPhone as soon as they wake up.
You know, it's funny you mention that. You know, when I was a kid, I used to watch the Brady Bunch, MASH, you know, certain shows, and I'd wake up to the Saturday night cartoons too and see Captain Caveman. But when I'd watch the Brady Bunch, and even going back into the 80s and the early 90s, a lot of the shows, they had meanings and they taught lessons.
Yes.
You know? For example, the Brady Bunch. I remember the episode where Bobby was playing with the ball in the house, and his mom said, "Don't play ball in the house."
Right.
And the ball hit the vase, and the vase broke.
Yeah.
And whatever, you know, what I learned: don't play ball in the house.
Right.
So these little shows and stuff, they had actually had meaning, and they had stuff. But now I watch the shows nowadays, and they're not really. I don't get anything out of it. You know, you got Love of Hip Hop. You got girls fighting each other. It just exploits everything, you know, on this TV that people like to watch. And to me, there's no intrinsic value.
Well, it's definitely changed because I do believe with reality TV, I think these days it's about the ratings and cheap programming. And so you have a lot of these reality shows that they have now that they didn't have when we were kids. And so it really sheds a different light in a lot of different ways. And sometimes, you know, sometimes it's real, sometimes it's scripted. But, you know, I think reality TV has kind of changed a lot of the programming that we watch today as well. It's just different. I think it's just different, you know, in 2016.
Yeah, you know, I'm not an avid reader, but I think a lot of us need to be trying to become avid readers, because when we grew up, we also had the source. We wanted to get information, we had to go to the source, or we had to go to the encyclopedia, you know, or the almanac.
How do you spell that word, Sid? Your mom saying, go look at the dictionary.
That's right.
Now you just type it in on Facebook, right, and it corrects it for you.
So therefore, what that means is you don't get a chance to exercise your brain. That's the most important part we're talking about here, people, is that exercising our brain. Our brain is a muscle. It needs to be exercised. You have to continuously keep working on it to make it better and better and better.
Freddie, where's your largest muscle?
Freddie's muscle is right here. He takes control.
He only thinks with one thing.
Only one head. He don't think up here like the rest of us normal people.
And like you said, you know, I think a lot of kids these days, some of them may not even know how to spell that good, because they're used to typing everything in, and the spell check does it automatically for them. And so it's different.
But what about the kids? I remember with my friends, we would go play Ding Dong Ditch, or we would go ride our bikes around the block. Kick the can, whatever it was, smear the queer. You know what I'm saying? Sid was familiar with that. We throw the ball up and he'd get the ball and we'd smear him. But no offense to anyone that's
yag.
So with that being said, the kids nowadays are mostly in the house. There's a problem with obesity like myself. I sit on my fat ass and just either be on Facebook or do other stuff instead of going out exercising, playing basketball, baseball, riding a skateboard. They got the things now where it's mostly computers and stuff.
Right? You know what I do with my kids? You know, we have a time of a disconnect. So when the family's eating together, I tell everybody, hey, let's get off our phones, let's all enjoy the meal together. You know, I actively take them out to go work out or go play at the park or do something, because I don't want them to just be in the house on their phones all the time. Now, I might be more of an active father than most fathers, because actually, my philosophy is I get money and I spend time with my kids. That's all I do. That's all I care about. Every once in a while, my friends and everything, I try to have lunch. But I try to be active in my children's lives so that, you know, they can just learn a lot of different things, see different things, be around different people, not just be on their phone or on the video games, you know, 24/7. And I think, you know, in this day and age, it's very easy for parents to just sit back and continue to do what they do and let their kids, you know.
So do you think, Chris, do you think technology is a blessing or a curse?
I think both, because it's a blessing, because the kids' minds are definitely moving faster and thinking in ways, and the accessibility to knowledge is the highest it's ever been just because of the internet. On the flip side of it, you know, there is more child obesity, and there are kids that are having more diseases as a result of not really doing anything. I think diabetes is higher now for children than it's ever been.
Yeah, and because the consumption of foods that they're intaking, of course, people out there that's paying attention and watching, and be careful and be cognizant, if you can, of what your children eat. And how much they eat of it. You know, they shouldn't consume a lot of McDonald's. They had this video where they poured like gasoline over McDonald's burger, and it didn't even move. It didn't melt, didn't do anything. So that's going inside of your system, and it's going to affect you in the long run. So, you know, try to be as health conscious as possible.
So what was the McDonald's in the 70s? What were we eating that was?
Well, now that's a good question. The McDonald's in the 70s was real meat. Cause you remember how thick the burger was? You couldn't even finish a McDonald's. You couldn't even finish a Big Mac.
I just remember going to Westwood and getting a 79-cent fillet of fish.
79-cent
fillet
of fish. $1 for a Big Mac.
I know it's bad for you, but I still like McDonald's. It's
the fries are still the best.
I do, and it's bad, and I know it's bad, but I've been eating it so long.
Yeah.
That really, it's like a comfort food for me.
What do you
like,
get? Chicken nuggets or a burger?
I'm a funny eater. I eat plain hamburgers, well done, with some French fries and some barbecue sauce. And wow, for me, I've been eating that since I was 10, 8.
Yeah, so you're comfortable with
that. Yeah, and you know, we all try to be as health conscious as we can be, because in this day and age, we try to be as healthy as we can.
Yes.
But
I like to challenge people real quick. So you had the ice bucket challenge. We've had all these different challenges. So I challenge America to put down the cell phones every day, whether it be with your sibling, with your kids,
for 2 hours a day.
For 2 hours a day, and have conversation.
At least spend some time. Yeah.
Spend some time. Get outside. I mean, throw the ball, roll the ball. Do something creative. Yeah. Something that's activity wise that they have to do, you know, play 60. But just get out there. Really, the communication is the most important part, people. We need to communicate, because we don't communicate like we used to, because everywhere you go, when you look around, I've seen people, I've been out to dinners, and I look at couples together, and they're literally on their fucking phone.
And not talking
to each other. Then I even seen a couple texting each other. It's that bad, you know? Yeah. So I challenge you to do that. At least an hour, 2 hours a day.
Force a time of disconnect. You know, whether it's with your significant other, your girlfriend, or your kids, for a small amount of time of a disconnect from the internet or from their phones, so that you can actually spend some quality time, you know, like the old Cosby Show and some of these other shows where people actually sat down and had dinners together and talked about things that were important for the family as a whole. I think it's a beautiful thing that it's kind of missing in today's society, because we're always running and gunning and you know, everybody's trying to make it in their own particular way, and sometimes you do have to take a step back from everything and just enjoy the moment. You know, just like what we do here. Before we even started filming any of this, we used to come out here and do this and really just spend time with each other and talk about current issues, tell some jokes, and really just enjoy the male bonding and true love. You know, we all come from different backgrounds, from different things, but we could all get together and not be on our phones and talk about some real issues, say some jokes, and really just enjoy ourselves, and which is what has brought us to, you know, to you guys today. You know, just spreading the love, especially in this day and age with all the hate and all the things going on. you know, you have three different guys from three different backgrounds. It's just all love. And you know, I feel I'm very fortunate to be a part of it and to be able to have found, you know, two other, you know, great guys.
And we want to thank all of our viewers for logging on, whether it's on YouTube or Facebook, and liking it, actually watching it, the content. And if there is something that you want us to talk about, or if you want us to say, you know, let us know and we'll go ahead and shout that out.
Yeah, by all means. Like you said, we appreciate you following us, and we're going to talk about stuff that's pertinent and, you know, try to get a message out there, as well as bring you some comedy involved with our man Ready Freddy here. So as the song said that Quincy Jones wrote one long time ago with Michael Jackson and Prince, rest in peace, we are the world. We are the
two. And this is Hard to Paint Real Talk, so we keep it real.
We
so
keep it real.
Thanks for watching.
See
we'll catch you guys
time.
Next time.
Peace out.
Have a good one. Peace.
We have to do our alma mater. We must do our alma mater. When I was a little baby boy, my grandmother watched the pigeon toy. Silver bells hanging on the string. She told me it was my to meet your grandma in school.